Hey everyone, in this tutorial, I will be showing you how to make this halo energy shield effect like this. So, if I change the power, you can increase the thickness of the electricity effect. You can also make all these effects. And here, if I turn on vertex color and go to vertex painting, I can actually paint this effect wherever I want. And I can also subtract the effect if I don't want it there, like this. This can be done for all the effects that I have shown here. So now I will go back and I will just turn off vertex colors. Here I can decrease the distortion amount to get straight lines, or I can increase it too much, like this. I can also increase the mesh size. So here we are actually using a shell mesh for this effect, and as you can see, the electricity effect is happening on top of the mesh. And here we have duplicated the mannequin mesh, but the poly count is reduced because I used the new skeletal mesh LOD system in Unreal Engine 4. So I get to duplicate the mannequin mesh but reduce the poly count of it using the LOD system. So the poly count on this shell mesh is not as much as the original mesh, and you can also decrease it even further if you want. So I could go here and I could go to the forced LOD model, and I can change this to like 4. Then as you can see, the LOD kind of changed. Now I will just compile this. So it doesn't look that much different, but you have actually reduced the poly count. So yeah, that's the new feature from the Unreal Engine we are going to be using. And also, you can go to the instance and you can change the number of bands like this. And you can also increase the power so the bands become very thin, like this. And you get some effect like this. You can also increase the U and V tiling alone, so you get some effect like this. And if I change the V tiling, you get something like this. And you can also change the tiling of the original material, so we get something like this. Now we can increase the speed or reduce it. Now we can do this only for the inner faces of the mesh, so we get something like this. You can also mask out the black color if you want. And now we can switch the coordinates, and we can also reduce the mesh size like this or increase it like this. And you can switch the coordinates. So if I switch the coordinate to a screen space coordinate, the lines will look continuous like this. And I can also use the mesh coordinates and it will look like this. So now, with this direction controls, I can control which direction the world position offset happens. So if I change the B value to 20, it will project upwards like this. And I can change the red value to 40, so it will come forward. And I will change the B to 1 and it looks like this. So you can have a lot of effects by controlling all the parameters. And you can change the color if you want. And this is also another effect I created with this. So basically, I just increased the V tiling to get this effect. And here we have an arrow like effect, and I can control a lot of stuff with this also. If I just use the vertex color, I can control where I want the arrows, like this. I can also paint where I want, like this, or I can subtract it from places that I don't want it. Like this. And here I have an outline effect. And here I have just a basic effect, like a shield going around the character. You can also create various other effects by controlling all the parameters and using different textures from the starter content or the textures you created. So this is what we are going to be creating today. And if you want to get the project files for this tutorial, you can support me on my Patreon. And for $5, you can get all the project files from my previous tutorials and this project file also. Or message me on Patreon or email me and I will upload them for you. So if you don't find a particular file you are looking for, just message me. So the first thing I'm going to create is a material. So to create that, right click, then go to material and I will call this m_energy. Then open it up. Then go to material properties, then go to blend mode and change this to translucent, because we need a translucent material, and change the shading model to unlit. We only need the MC color, the opacity and the world position offset. Tick two-sided if you also want to have the outline effects like this. So I'm just going to tick two-sided. So now we will get a material function to create the electricity effect. So to do that, right click, then go to function, then material function call, then here type in 4-way motion, 4-way chaos, and if you don't see this, just go to view options and tick show engine contents, then select this. And here we have three nodes: coordinate node, the speed node and the divisor node, and there's a texture node. So we will bring in a texture from our starter content. So go to the starter content and go to textures. Then I will bring in this smoke texture. So here we can't really connect this to the texture input because it need a texture object. So right click, then convert this to a texture object. Then connect this here. Then get a scalar parameter by pressing and holding S and clicking. And change this to divisor. And then duplicate that by pressing Ctrl W. Then change the name of this to speed. Then connect this to speed and give a value of 1 for speed and give a value of 1 for divisor for now. So essentially what this motion for a chaos is doing is that it is just panning the textures in all the four directions. So we get this kind of effect that you can see here. And the speed kind of controls the speed of the panel, and the divisor kind of controls the, so if the divisor value is 0, we will get a 0 value out of it, and if the divisor value is 1, we will get all of this effect here, and we can kind of control the power of this effect using this divisor value. So now we will create some bands. So there are multiple ways to create this. So right click and type in linear gradient. Then connect this to the UV channel. So if I get a multiply node and I will connect the vertical gradient here, and if I preview this, you can see that there's a vertical gradient happening here. So there's a zero value at top and a white value at one, and a white value or a value of one at the bottom. So we need multiple gradients like this. So to do that, we can get a fract node. So it basically only gets a decimal portion of a value. So if you press and hold Ctrl and Alt and pan over the expressions, you can see what it does. So here a fract expression takes in values and output the decimal part. So what that means is that if it has a value of 0.1, the output will be 0.1, and for 0.2 the output will be 0.2. So it will just give us a decimal part of those values. So now if you multiply this gradient with a scalar value, I will call this number, and for 1 we will get the exact same output, and I will just start previewing this. And if I change the number to 2, you can see that there is two gradients now. And 5, there is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gradient. So you can increase the number of the bands like this. There's also a node called generate bands, which can also be used for this, I think. So now we need some of these gradients to be black and some of this to be white. So to do that, we can just sign this. So I will show you how a sign node works. So if I get a constant 1 value and I connect this to sign, the output of the sign will be 0 or black, and if I give a value of 0.1, it will be white, and 0.2, it will also be white but increase in brightness, and 0.3 also give a white color, but 0.5 will give a black color, and 0.6 will also give a black color. So it kind of repeats, and 1 will give a black color, but 1.1 will give a white color. So it kind of repeats like that. So if I connect this here, so now I can get this alternating black and white stripes like this. So now we need to distort these bands to get the electricity effect like this. So to do that, we can get a textured coordinate by pressing and holding U and clicking, and we can get an add node and connect this to A and connect this to the UV channel of this linear gradient, and now connect this to the B. So we will get an error because even though we are giving a scalar value here, the output we are getting from here is a 3 vector, which is RGB. We don't really want the color value because a texture coordinate is just a 2 vector. Here you can see that there is only green and red values, and we are kind of adding a 3 vector to a 2 vector, which doesn't really work. So we need to make this either a scalar or a 2 vector. So here for our purposes, we just need a scalar value. So to make this scalar, we can just mask this or get an RGB mask and just tick the R value. We just need a scalar value here. And now connect this to B. Now we can see that it is distorting the bands and giving us a electric kind of looking effect. So now I will just decrease the numbers, and I will also decrease the divisor like this. So this is what we get. So here if we connect this to the opacity, the black value will make that portion invisible and the white value will make that portion visible. So if I connect this to the opacity and I will stop previewing this, you can see that the points where there are the black colors, it is invisible, and the white portions are visible but black in color because we haven't really given an MVC color to this yet. So get a vector parameter by pressing and holding V and clicking, and I will name this color and connect this to the MVC color and change the R value to 1. So we get a red color. So now we have given a red color to our material. Okay, now I will just comment all of this and call this electric effect. Now we need to fine tune these values. So to do that, we will get a power node. Then we will get a multiply node. And we will get a clamp node because we don't really want this value to go above 1 or below 0. Now get a scalar parameter by pressing and holding S and clicking. And now I will call this POW for power and give a default value of 1. And I will create another scalar parameter and I will call this multiply. And I will also give this a default value of 1 and I will connect this to B. Then we will multiply this with the color and we will connect this to the MVC color. And now we will connect this to the opacity. Now click apply and go to the content browser, then right click and create material instance, then open it up. So here with this material instance, we can control all the parameters easily. So now I have a very bright orange color. Now I will just increase the power. It will make the effect a bit more thinner. All the lines will be a bit more thinner if you increase the power. I will change this to blue color so it looks like lightning. Now by increasing the multiply, we will make the lines that are showing even more brighter, like this. So this is a great way of making the lines thinner but also brighter by controlling the power and the multiply nodes. So we get something like this. We can also reduce the number of lines like this. If you want, you can increase the speed or decrease the speed, and you can also increase or decrease the divisor value. So if I give it a 0 value, we will only get a line like this, and if I give a value of 0.1, we will get something like this. I will give a value of 0.6, so we get something like this. So now we have an electric effect. Now to create rest of the effects. So now I will just comment this and call this fine tune. And I will comment this color. Now to create the vertex animations. So to do that, get a vertex normal node. It will just give the vertex normal of the mesh like this. So the points which are pointing upwards will have a blue color, and sideways will have a green color, and front and forward it will have a red color, because here you can see the x, y and z axis. So here the black values aren't actually zero but are negative values. So here opposite to the red, this black color is actually -1 for red, and green is -1 for R, and here the blue is also -1 for C. So it will allow us to push the mesh in different directions. So now to control the directions, we can get a multiply and get another vector parameter by pressing and holding V and clicking. And I will call this direction, then connect this to the multiply. Now we will get another multiply and get a scalar parameter and call this mesh size. So this parameter will allow us to control the overall size of our mesh and connect this here. So there's a problem here, because if we give 0, 0, 0 for all the direction values, then the output of this will be 0 and the output of this will be also 0, and the mesh size won't really work. So in order to get past that, we can actually change the multiply node and replace that with a max node. So here whichever has the maximum value, we get as an output from here. So even if this is all 0, the output from this won't be 0. So I will just change this to 2. Now we will multiply this value with the texture like this, and now we can connect this to the world position offset, and we will connect this to the opacity, and we will connect this to the MC color, and I will just drag and comment this. So to comment this, you can just press C, and I will call this vertex offset. Now if I click apply, and I can just change the mesh size using this. So I can increase or decrease the mesh size. And now I can change the direction in which the increase happens. So if I give G a value of 5, it kind of looks like this. See? I can also give a value of 10 for B. So it also look like it is going upwards. Like this. So now to control which side you want to show, whether it is the outer side of the mesh or the inner side. To control this, we can get a node called two-sided node. So basically what this node does is that if I preview this, so it will just output a white color or a value of 1 if we are looking at the outside of the mesh, and if we are looking at the inside of the mesh, it will just output a value of 0. So if you want to see only the inside of the mesh to get an outline effect like this, we can actually 1 minus this and get a multiply node and connect this here, and now we will get a switch parameter. So we can switch between the inside and the outside of the mesh. So we will drag and type in switch parameter, and we will call this only show inside, and if it is false, we will actually give our original input. And now we can connect this to the opacity. Now click apply. You don't really have to do this if you only want this electricity effect. Now I will just drag all of this and I will comment this, and I will call this inside. Now I will click apply. Now if I select only show inside and tick this, here we can only see the inside of the mesh. It isn't really visible that much, but if I go to the map and place a cylinder in, and I will duplicate the cylinder again, and now I will apply this to the cylinder, and if I place a cylinder on top of it, you can see that only the inner mesh is showing. And now if I reduce the size of the sphere, so now you can see that there is nothing in front of the cylinder because only the back faces are showing, like this. So now to create this aura effect and this shielding effect, we need to use a different texture for that. So I will go to the material again. Now I will go to the starter content in this and bring in this tea water texture. And now I will just drag this speed and divisor here, and I will just duplicate this motion forward chaos and mask R, and I will bring it here, and I will just convert this to a texture object. And here after the sign, we will do parameter, and I will call this switch types. Again, you only have to do this if you only want this aura effect to be present. So I think before this, I will just show you how to make the shell armor for the third person character. So to do that, I will go to the mannequin folder, then go to the mesh folder, then I will just duplicate this mannequin mesh, and I will call this shell mesh VP for vertex painting. Then I will open up the third person character. Now I will just drag in the shell mesh VP like this, and I will bring it down like this, and I will just rotate this. So here you can see that our mesh isn't following the animation. So to fix that, we can go here and just drag in the shell mesh VP. The other shell mesh is the one I created before. So you just have to focus on the shell mesh VP, then bring that in, then type in set master pose component, then connect this here. Remember, we are doing this on the construction script because we want to be able to see this before we play the game. Now bring in our mesh the original skeletal mesh and connect this here, then compile. So now you can see that our shell mesh is also following the animations. You can also copy the location and just paste it, so it will match properly. And you can also copy the rotations, so it matches up perfectly. Now I will just hide this original mesh, so we can just see our shell mesh. Now select the shell mesh and you can type in LOD, and we will get this LOD system. And here if I change the value to 4, so now here you can see that the poly count has changed. So even though we are duplicating the mesh, we are not duplicating all the polygons on the mesh. So it is a bit more efficient this way. You can give a value of 1, which will look closer to the mesh. And the original value of LOD is actually 0. That is the original mesh. And 1 will give a mesh with less polygons. And 2 will give a mesh with a even lower polygons. And 3, 4, like that. So, whichever you like, you can pick. So, the fourth one has the lowest polygon counts. I will just change this to 1 for now. So, here you can see override materials. So, just add an element. We just need one material node here. So, now we can bring in our electric instance and add it here. So, here you can see that the chest isn't actually working. Now you can also add that material to the chest logo like this. Now I will make the original mesh visible. So now we have something like this. Now click compile. And now I will just open this up. And I will increase the size of the mesh to 5. And directions, I will give a value of 0. I think I made a small mistake here. So let's go to the material, then go to the vertex offset. Then here we will get a multiply and control drag this in and delete the max because it was causing some problems. And connect this to A and connect this to B. Then for directions, set one for R, G and B. Then click apply. So now you can just drag in your third person character like this. And we will change the direction to 111 here. So now we get something like this. Now here we will untick this. Surely inside we will untick that. So now we get something like this. Now we can increase this power. So we get an electric looking effect like this. So here we have two elements. We don't really need this. So delete that. So it just free up the Unreal Engine logo portion in the middle. So it will look a bit more cleaner. Now to paint using the vertex color, go to the material. Then right click, then type in vertex color. Then get a multiply node and I will comment this vertex color. Then we will just control drag all of this here like this. Now we will get a switch parameter. So type in switch parameter, static switch parameter. Then I will call this use vertex color. So we will just control drag this here. And if this is true, we will multiply this with this. So we will multiply the vertex color with the texture. And we will connect this to true. And if this is false, then we can directly connect this output from the clamp to the false. So if you don't want to use the vertex color, then the input that we connect to the false will come out of here. Now we will click apply Now select the mesh, then go to the paint. Then you can go here and view RGB channels, so we can see the places where we have painted. So here you can see that everything is white, and white means that it has a value of 1. So the effect is applied to everywhere which has a value of 1. So in order to paint this, first we have to change all of this to black. So to do that, we will just change this color to black and just press the fill selected mesh. So everything will be black. Now we will change this back to white. And we will turn this off. Then go to the material instance. Then tick use vertex color. Then tick this. Now it is using vertex color, but we can see anything because everything has a value of 0. Now if I start painting like this, so just apply this to everything. So now you can just paint. Now if I change this color wheel to off, you can see that it is only showing at and paint here if I want to, and paint here also. So we get something like this. So now in order to make the arrow effect use so, we can go to the material. Then we will connect this to the false, and now we will connect this to the base. Now here we will connect this texture here, and for the divisor we will bring in our divisor, and for the speed we will bring in our speed, and now click apply. Now go to the instance. Now you can switch the type like this. So if I switch it, we are not able to see it. Now I will just decrease the power. So now we will be able to see it like this. And I will untick use vertex color. So now we have something that looks like this. So now we will create the arrow effect. So to do that, we can just increase the B value to like 50 or like 25. Now you can see that now we need to control the tiling of the texture. So in order to do that, we can go to the material. Then using this UV coordinates here and here, we can control the tiling. Now we will get a texture coordinate by pressing and holding U and clicking. Now we will get a multiply. And we will get a scalar parameter, and we will call this tiling, and I will default this to 1. Now get another multiply, and we will get an append node. So this is just to control the tiling in one particular axis, that is horizontal or vertical. So now we will get another create another scalar parameter and call this U tiling. And default this to 1 also, and connect this to A, and duplicate this, and now change the name to V tiling and connect this to B. Now I will just comment this and call this tiling. Now connect this to the UVs here. And we can also connect this to the UVs here. Now click apply. Now we can go to the instance. So now we can increase the tiling like this. So it will become finer and finer. So there is also one more problem. Here you can see that the arrows are going downwards because we are multiplying it with the negative of this vertex normal also. And if you don't want that, then we can just clamp this between 0 and 1, so it doesn't take in the negative values of the vertex normal, and our arrows only go upwards. So now you can increase the power value, and also increase the divisor like this, and increase the mesh size if you want. And now we can use vertex color, and now we can just paint where we want, and we can also press shift and paint so that we will delete or erase some of the paints like this. Now we will tick surely inside. So now our arrows looks like this. We can also paint some more if you want. Now if you want different effects for different meshes, you can just create a material instance and just place that in to the shell mesh VP. So I will just add this in, and now I can just change the color. So it will change the color, and I can change the tiling to 1, and I will change the direction to 1 for B. Click use vertex color and untick this. Now I will just switch types, and now I will just tick only show inside and untick this. Now we get something like this. Now we can increase the power, so we get this look. Now to get those lines that you saw in the beginning, you can just increase the V tiling to 10. So you get a line like this, and you can decrease the power to like 50. So you get something like this, and you can also switch types to get different result like this, and you can change the color, and you can increase the overall tiling or decrease it to get a different result. Now to get the outline you saw earlier, you can just tick only show inside, so it will only happen the outer portions of the mesh. Now we will just decrease the power to 1 and decrease the multiply value. So now we have something like this. Now you can just change the mesh size to 1, so it looks like this, or to 0, or change it to 1, and then we can change the V tiling to 1. So now it looks like this. So in order to get the arrow like effect, it is better to use the water texture. Then we can just change the divisor value to 1 and change the tiling to like 100 or 50. Then we can increase the B value to like 45. So it kind of looks like an aura. Now we can just use the vertex color for a mask. So now it looks like this. Now we can just increase the power or decrease it to get a totally different effect. Now we can just erase all these portions if you want. You can also experiment with using different textures to get different results. So there are a lot of textures here. You can experiment with each of them. So if I use this fire texture, you might get a different result. So I'll just use that and click apply. So now I got something like this. Now I will just decrease the tiling and nothing happens. So I'll just increase the tiling to 1 and decrease the divisor to 0.2. So we get something like this. And now I can decrease the power to 0.1 also, or power to like 50 or 20, 10, 2, 5, 1. And also I can increase the multiply to 100 or 1 or 0.1 or 2. So all of this will give us different results, and you can play around with these values to get something completely different. You can get something like this if you want. And you can also paint the values using the vertex color. You can change the U tiling or the V tiling. So all of this have minimal effects right now. So now we got something like this. So yeah, you can play around with all these values to get a result you want. And here, for this I can just go to the material instance and just I will untick show inside. And now I will increase the power to 50 or 500. And I will just switch the type of the texture used. So now we have something like this. And we can just change the color like normal. Now we can use the vertex color. And we can paint it where we want. We can also increase the number and reduce the power to 2 or 10 or 50 to get looks like this. And you can also increase the B offset by 50, so we get something like this. Or we will change this to 5, so we can get something like this. So that's it guys, thanks for watching, and if you want to download the project files, you can support me on my Patreon. Thanks.